das ja nicht immer genau, aber dieses Mal wusste ich ganz genau, wie toll das werden kann, wenn man die auch mal zusammen hier bringt nach Frankfurt. Und freuen Sie sich auf beseelte Musik, die wir auch live übertragen werden im Radio und auch im Internet. Und deshalb stehe ich eigentlich hier, ich will Ihnen das sagen, dass Sie Teil einer Live-Übertragung sind und wie immer um Ihre Mithilfe bitten, weil wir brauchen einen schönen Applaus am Anfang der Sendung. Das, ja. Und ja, na, stopp, stopp. Ich wollte gerade sagen, das können wir üben, jetzt mal so richtig. Und zwar sind ja noch nicht alle da, aber die HR Big Band ist schon da, die Herren in Schwarz. Also vielleicht hier gleich mal zum Üben einen wunderbaren Applaus für die Herren in Schwarz. So wird das was und nachher natürlich noch kräftiger, wenn Sie mögen. So, jetzt, es war aber schon sehr gut. Jetzt warten wir gemeinsam aufs Radiosignal, da können Sie Ihre Uhr nachstellen. Ich habe hier die Atomuhr, 20.03 Uhr, das ist jetzt also noch ungefähr noch 45 Sekunden, dann kommt das Signal von H2, nicht erschrecken, und dann sind wir drauf. Ich wünsche Ihnen viel Vergnügen heute Abend und ja, viel Spaß. Danke.
Die beiden kennen sich seit nun mehr als 20 Jahren. Sie verbindet eine persönliche Freundschaft, die vor allem in einem großen musikalischen Verständnis füreinander zusammenfließt. Zenon ist heute einer der einflussreichsten Saxophonisten seiner Generation. Sicher auch, weil er es geschafft hat, seine musikalische Herkunft aus Puerto Rico mit dem modernen Jazz zu verbinden. Guillermo Klein wiederum verbindet die Musik Argentiniens mit all den Tangos und Charangas, mit seiner Liebe für die klassische Musik, insbesondere die modernen Komponisten wie Bartok, Stravinsky oder auch Ligeti. Guillermo Kleins Musik, die so entsteht, ist berührend und fordernd zugleich und entwickelt eine unglaubliche Kraft. Sie hören HR2 Kultur. Auf der Bühne ist alles bereit. Wir gehen jetzt in den HR-Sendesaal zur HR-Bigband mit dem Saxophonisten Miguel Zenon unter der Leitung von Guillermo Klein.
Thank you very much. Dr. Chairman, thank you. Thank you so much. Such a pleasure to be here in Frankfurt with this wonderful band and all these friends. Very, very grateful for the opportunity to be here and play music and share with all of you. I wanted to say something really briefly about this first song, which you just heard. It's called Tiemblas. And this is a song that comes out of the Puerto Rican songbook. It was written by an amazing composer and songwriter, one of the greatest in the history of Latin American music. His name was Tite Curet Alonso. And he wrote a lot of music for in the 60s and 70s for the salsa genre, a lot of dance music and also a lot of slow sort of songs like this one. And this is a song that I sort of arranged for quartet and Guillermo orchestrated initially for a woodwind ensemble, and now he expanded that orchestration for the orchestra. Really, really happy to get to play that with everyone here. We're gonna continue now with a piece by Guillermo. He wrote this one based on an Argentine poem, and this one is called Riqueza Abandonada. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Chair. Thank you.
Danke schön. Martin Scales und la guitarra. It's a pleasure and an honor to be here tonight sharing music with Miguel and this wonderful band here in Frankfurt. This next piece we're going to play is a very, very new piece. Some pieces we're going to play is the first time we play them. It's called Criolla. Criolla means like Creole, like from your homeland, no? Criolla. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Danke. Stefan Karl Schmidt. Hier ist Stefan. The next two pieces we'll play, they are very old Argentine tangos, written by Carlos Gardel, who is an icon of Argentinian music. We have few icons: Gardel, Piazzolla, Charlie Garcia, Spinetta, like in the pantheon. Yeah, Maradona. No, I'm talking about music. Don't get me there. Don't get me there. Okay, and. I share this music with Miguel and now with the band. Needless to say that Miguel is one of my favorite musicians in the world. So that's what I mean. I'm very honored to do this with him. And also one of my best friends. So it's quite a treat to do this. So I hope you enjoy these views of our Argentine music. This one is called Volver. And after that one, we're going to do Melodía de Arrabal. Thank you, Sven. Thank you very much. You heard Axel Schlosser on the solo flute. Hans Klawiśnicz en el bajo. We're gonna play the last tune of this part. It's originally, when I wrote this tune, it's called Con Brasil Adentro, Fugue X. It has a kind of like a prelude and then a fugue, and it's based on a Bach fugue. And then after I wrote this tune, I wrote a fugue on top of the fugue, so you will hear a double fugue. And I was very nervous to bring it to the band, and they just played like that. So I hope you enjoy this tune, and we'll take a break and we'll come back. Thank you.
Wir sind nun Heinz-Dieter Sauerbund. Wir Heinz, the band. Beautiful. See you in a bit. Thank you very much.
Einen schönen guten Abend, auch in meinem Namen in HR2 Kultur und auf den Social-Media-Kanälen der HR Big Band. Ich bin glücklich, denn ich habe hier in der Pause des heutigen Konzerts Noticias de Zenoni Klein zwei wundervolle Gäste zu Gast im Studio, Miguel Zenon und Guillermo Klein. I'm very pleased to have you here. Hola to
Hola.
You both.
Hi. Hello. Hola. Good to be here.
Well, imagine, we're just after the second rehearsal you did with a band you worked since last week, Guillermo. But it's the intermission. You already played a half with a big band right now. It's not your first projects with the Frankfurt Radio Big Band. You already played with both of you. Mm-hmm. How is it to be back, Guillermo?
It's really great. It feels great, feels better too, feels like we are friends, you know, like in a good way, musically and like personally, more relaxed and better too, more together. That's how I feel.
Miguel, for you?
Kind of the same, you know. I think it makes a difference once you, once you've met people beforehand and you kind of know them personally and you know what to expect musically. It feels like it's a relationship now. You know, it's not just like a one time thing, but it's kind of you're building a relationship with an organization and a band, which feels really great.
Miguel Zenon und Guillermo Klein, auf die erste Frage, die ich Ihnen gestellt habe, wie sich es anfühlt. Sie sind nicht das erste Mal zu Gast bei der HR Big Band. Beide haben schon mit dem HR Ensemble zusammengespielt. Die erste Antwort kam von Guillermo, der sagt, dass es sich gut anfühlt, dass es schön ist, hier zu sein, dass es natürlich noch besser werden kann, dadurch, dass man sich schon besser kennt. Und Miguel sagt, es ist so etwas wie eine Art von einer Freundschaft, die man begründet hat und dass man sich dann eben durch das Besserkennen eben auch anders und vielleicht sogar besser miteinander spielen kann. I start again with you, Guillermo. You are responsible as well for the compositions, but for the arrangements as well. And you've been working a lot with Miguel before. You are, I would say, like friends already in a musical way, of course. Was there, is it different thinking of writing for the big band and Miguel now than the last time where you only wrote your music for the band?
Of course, yeah, very, very, it's very different. I was thinking about what Miguel would like to play, how will he feel, about what the band would like to play, how will the band feel, what I would like to write, how. And, you know, I know Miguel for more than 20 years now, and we've been playing for that long, so we have a whole rainbow of adventures in music. So I was like, okay, I want to play music that comes from Miguel, a couple of tunes. Miguel had the idea, he had the arrangements, I orchestrate them and adapt for the band. I brought some Argentine music too that I know he likes. And then I some tunes of mine that I think he would like to play, and some new stuff. So it was a wide array of things. And from the very beginning of the project, I was very enthusiastic and very clear and happy about it, you know, which is not often that happens to me. Yeah.
Ein glücklicher Guillermo Klein, der sagt, dass auf die Frage, die ich ihm gestellt habe, wie es ist, er hat für die HR Big Band schon vorher Musik geschrieben, aber dieses Mal wusste er, er schreibt nicht für die Band alleine, sondern schon mit einem Gastsolisten, Miguel Zenon, der noch mit dabei ist, und deswegen wollte ich von ihm wissen, ob das sich anders angefühlt hat, und er sagt natürlich. Die Auswahl der Stücke war für ihn ganz anders zu treffen als zuvor. Es ging ihm darum, sowohl Stücke zu finden, die Miguel mag, es ging darum, Stücke zu finden, die Guillermo selber sehr gerne mag, und natürlich Sachen zu finden, die aus ihrer Kultur kommen. Er hat argentinische Tangos auch mitgebracht, darüber werden wir sicherlich auch noch sprechen. Und es war für ihn spannend, das alles zusammenzuwerfen und eben jetzt in dieses Projekt hineinzutun. Miguel, you come from Puerto Rico, Guillermo comes from Argentina. Let's say, if I don't know anything about Puerto Ricans and Argentinians, what is the biggest difference between both of you?
You know, one way to think about this is to think about Latin America as a really large place. I mean, very, very large, with a bunch of different countries. And even within those countries, you have a lot of different elements, you know, especially if you're speaking about music, you know, even within Puerto Rico, which is maybe, I don't know, 100 times smaller than Argentina or something like that. You still have a lot of different elements depending on where you are. You know, so each country is going to have their own kind of personality in a way. Some countries are going to be closer together and more connected. Like if you think about the Caribbean as kind of like a zone, or Central America. And then you got North and South America and Southern South America. And they all have like specific kind of, you know, personalities. But there's also a lot of similarities as well. You know, I mean, one of the songs that we were playing in the program is this song Alma Adentro, which is a song by a Puerto Rican composer, Silvia Resach, and it's sort of like a song, you know, a popular song from the 40s. When I was talking to Guillermo, we started working on that song. He heard it as a tango because he has the same kind of personality, you know. So you start seeing there's a lot of things that are very similar and a lot of some things that are different, and the differences are, you know, I think the differences are less important than the similarities. I think the similarities is kind of what brings a lot of this music together. And I think in the case of the two of us, it kind of goes beyond that, obviously. I mean, goes beyond whatever our music from our own countries it's about, and it's more about finding just like a personal connection and you know, that kind of thing, friendship.
Miguel Sennon, auf die Frage, ich habe natürlich ein bisschen provokant gestellt, Sie beide kommen aus Südamerika, der eine Guillermo aus Argentinien und Miguel aus Puerto Rico, und ich wollte wissen, ob es denn da Unterschiede zwischen den beiden gibt. Und er sagt natürlich, sie sind beide aus dem Teil, den man auch Lateinamerika nennt, und da gibt es natürlich Unterschiede, aber eigentlich gibt es auch schon in seinem eigenen Land Puerto Rico auch schon dort große Unterschiede zwischen den Leuten. Puerto Rico ist außerdem wesentlich kleiner als Argentinien als Land, aber es gibt eben auch Gemeinsamkeiten. Und er hat ein Beispiel genommen von einem Stück, das im Programm mit drin ist. Es heißt, ich muss es gerade selber gucken, Alma Adentro, das eigentlich aus Puerto Rico kommt, und Guillermo hat es aufgenommen wie ein Tango. Für ihn hat es sich angefühlt und richtig angefühlt, es als Tango zu verstehen. Und das funktioniert, obwohl sie aus verschiedenen Ländern sind. Die Gemeinsamkeit ist wahrscheinlich die lateinamerikanische Herkunft. Außerdem verbindet sie beide eine Freundschaft, die natürlich über Ländergrenzen hinweg geht. Miguel, but coming back to you as a musician, I found that you have been interested in finding a mix of jazz and folkloristic music from your own country. And this is also for you, Guillermo, because you don't live in Argentina right now anymore. There is a difference between living in your own country and being far away or in the being foreign somewhere, and then thinking of your own music, your own heritage. How does it feel for you to perform this music being in Europe, in Frankfurt, Germany now?
Right. So I think, at least in my case, like you mentioned, I grew up in Puerto Rico and eventually ended up in the United States. To be honest, it wasn't until I moved to the United States that I was able to connect at a deeper level with Puerto Rican music in terms of what it meant to me. You know, I mean, I had a certain understanding of it while living in Puerto Rico, but it wasn't until I had the perspective of being far away that I was able to appreciate it for what it was, and I was able to find things in it that I could use for my own musical development. You know, so that took a little time. And it's interesting, you know, because when you're dealing with music that's very connected to folklore, which is like the purest music there is, you know, I mean, it's like music from the people, and it could connect with anyone. You know, I mean, I could play songs or rhythms or little melodies that someone might recognize from the source. That is something that's okay, so I know where that's from. And then go somewhere else where people might not know where it's from, but they still recognize it as something that has that kind of personality, something that's folkloric and has that feel to it, you know. So, you know, a lot of times when you go to Europe or other places where people might not know the source or the origins of the music, my experience is that they still hear something in the music and say, okay, so that has a little something that's coming from the earth, like from the ground up, you know. So it's sort of universal, like the connection is universal. Even if you don't know where it's coming from, you still kind of feel it. I that's my experience anyway.
Miguel Sennon, auf die Frage, er ist ins Ausland gegangen, er lebt heute in New York, kommt aber aus Puerto Rico, und ich wollte wissen, ob es für ihn sich auch so anfühlt, dass wenn man gerade in der Ferne ist und nicht mehr in seiner eigenen Heimat lebt, dass es sich anders anfühlt, sich mit der eigenen Kultur zu beschäftigen, dahinter zu gucken, wo komme ich eigentlich her, was für eine musikalische Herkunft habe ich. Und er sagt, ja, das stimmt in der Tat, er musste erst nach New York gehen, um quasi seine eigene Musik wieder anders zu entdecken, von außen zu betrachten, sie Leuten vorzustellen, die dann wiederum eventuell manchmal das Gefühl haben, das kenne ich irgendwie oder das erinnert mich an etwas, das könnte daher kommen. Etwas sehr Tiefes, was man mit dieser Musik verbindet, ohne eigentlich genau zu wissen, was es ist. Guillermo, I would like to know the same for you. You don't live in Argentina, where you come from. You're still connected a lot to the music where you came from. But where did you find this love to your music? At home or gone away and listening and thinking of it?
Well, I don't think on those terms. I have to say, like, for me, all the music is folkloric music, you know? And I just react to the music I like. And I like as a writer to find connections. because, you know, if you hear tango music, what is tango music? It's a romantic harmonies that come from Chopin or Tchaikovsky and Brahms and this Italian type of vibe, melodies, and then the rhythm. So everything is connected. So my approach to music in general is very wild. So I react to things that I like and that I connect. The thing about being outside of your country is an added situation. That's a very interesting topic because you find yourself, for example, I cannot listen to Astor Piazzolla at home if I'm sensitive or if I feel nostalgic. I cannot listen to it because it breaks me in two. It brings me a lot of memories. And sometimes that's what happened for an expatriate musician. That's why it's very common that the people that leave their own country start playing music of their country, because they're not playing music of the country, they're playing music of their lives. You're trying to reincorporate some aspect of your own life that comes inevitable. So if it, and as we are working on expression, so that comes inevitable, you have to share it, and you find the way to share it from your now, and that's it's quite a trip, and to honor that source, you know, and to make that source viable and still fluid, and that's my take on what we call folklore, you know. It's very whimsical and it's very personal too, you know.
Eine Antwort von Guillermo Kleim auf die ähnliche Frage, wie es sich für ihn anfühlt, der aus Argentinien kommt. Seine Musik, eben zum Beispiel den Tango, der natürlich für Argentinien steht, in der Ferne zu spielen. Er sagt als allererstes, dass sich für ihn sein Verständnis von Musik machen ganz anders anfühlt. Er ist nicht der Meinung, dass er es so aufzieht. Für ihn hat die ganze Welt ist quasi von Folklore Musik umgeben. Also es gibt überall Folklore und es geht ihm vor allen Dingen erstmal darum, eine Musik zu mögen, sie zu lieben und so weiter. Und interessanterweise erzählt er, dass wenn er zu Hause ist, könnte er, wenn er in einer bestimmten Stimmung ist, niemals Piazzolla hören, weil ihn das viel zu traurig macht. Und weil es Erinnerungen weckt an etwas, was er vielleicht vermisst oder nicht mehr hat. Also es geht eher darum, das rauszufinden, was ihn besonders berührt und womit er gerne zu tun haben will. Ich sag noch einmal, wir sind in der Pause vom Konzert Noticias de Zenoni Klein mit der HR Big Band. Ich habe zwei wundervolle Gäste, Miguel Zenon und Guillermo Klein, die im Studio sind. Sie hören vielleicht HR2 Kultur oder schauen einen der Social Media Kanäle von der HR Big Band. Und die Zeit rennt, es bleibt nicht mehr gar nicht so viel Zeit. Guillermo, when I listened to you rehearsing with the band, also before Miguel came, I realized that you are very focused on the work you do, which means really work the songs really hard as well. The band had to work really hard to perform the music because it's rhythmically very interesting. It has a variety and it has parts of virtuosity as well. You have to practice the music that you play, but at the same time, when I listen to it, it feels very like, how can I say, it has to be the way it is.
That's good.
It sounds very natural. Does this music just come out of you, or do you really have to work hard to find it in your work?
I'm 5 minutes, man. Just, of course, I work really hard. Of course, but that's. I like that you say natural. For me, that's a key word. The key word. I can't go to a band. I can't just go to a band and ask them to work and play music that is not natural to me, you know. I can't not do that. I can't sleep after that, and because it has to come from me. If I'm gonna demand them, they might need my help and they might need me to play some melodies. They might need me to play some grooves. It has to, and that's the only way music transcends yourself, and that's the only way it makes people. The people that is performing it eager to make it happen, you know, because it's like you say, it has to be. So in order to get to that point of it has to be, you know, the typical thing that happens to me is I have an idea and it comes like that, and then I look at that idea from 20 different angles and I change it and I work, and then I end up with the first idea, but I know it is that's the thing, And I don't care if I take too much time or I'm very slow. Maybe my wife cares because I get very obsessed with my kids when I play. But, you know, that's what makes me, like you've been in the rehearsal, totally transparent and happy to be here. And the work that takes before is what it makes this thing vital, you know? Yeah.
Ein glücklicher Guillermo Klein auf die Frage, wie schwer es für ihn ist, diese Arrangements, die er schreibt, herzustellen. Ich habe ihm gesagt, dass ich bei den Proben zuschauen durfte und mir einfach aufgefallen ist, dass trotz einer Musik, die für die Musiker sehr komplex ist, sprich ich habe die Musiker von der HR Big Band wirklich üben gehört, weil es Material gibt, das viel Virtuosität und Technik abverlangt, eine Musik dabei herauskommt, die etwas sehr Natürliches hat. Eine Musik, die sich anfühlt, genau so muss sie sein. Und das wollte ich von Guillermo wissen. Er hat mir zugestimmt und sich gefreut, dass ich gesagt habe, dass genau dieses Gefühl dabei entsteht, von Natürlichkeit. Das ist ihm sehr wichtig und er arbeitet hart daran. Er sagt, dass seine Familie da bisweilen ihre Schwierigkeiten hat, weil er natürlich viel dafür am Klavier sitzt und arbeitet. Aber es kommt aus ihm heraus, aber es braucht seine Zeit, bis diese Musik in ihrer ganzen Art dann auch entstanden und geschehen ist. Miguel, to finish this intermission talk with you, you are the main saxophone player. There are five more to play with you in the band. How is it to perform this music that Miguel has arranged? Is it something that you are really used to? Do you recognize this music, or is it special for you to play?
It's always special. I mean, like Guillermo mentioned, we've been playing together for a very, very long time. I always kind of tell this story about me being a fan of his music even before meeting him, just kind of following him around and like just going to all the shows and eventually getting to play the music. And I felt when I first started playing the music, I felt like I knew it already, you know, because I was such a fan. And I feel the same way still, you know. I mean, a lot of these pieces, some of them are familiar. Some of them are things that we've played together before in other bands and other configurations, either my own project or Guillermo's projects. A few of them are new, but even the new ones feel familiar because they feel like they're coming out of Guillermo, and I feel like I know his music well. So it's always special. I mean, it's always special to get to play music, get to make music with him, and I feel like the opportunity to get a band like this one that's at a very high level and takes things very seriously makes the experience just feel very comfortable and just it's just a really nice experience in general. You know, I get opportunities once in a while to do things like this where you just kind of go in front of a band and play solo as a featured soloist, but they're not all coming from the place where, like you know the composer really well or some of the music you're very familiar with. So it's not just going up there and playing a solo, but it's like you get inside of the music as well as a player, and you're hearing, you know, I'm enjoying what he wrote, and you're getting to that as well. So the experience, I think it goes a little beyond just being a featured soloist for me. I think I'm just kind of like a soloist, but I'm also just, I feel like I'm just part of the music and part of what's being developed.
Very nice ending word from Miguel Zenón. Miguel Zenón, auf die Schlussfrage, die ich stellen musste, die Pause in dem Konzert Noticias de Zenón y Klein ist fast zu Ende. Freue mich, dass Sie zugehört haben. Ich möchte aber natürlich so zusammenfassen, was er gesagt hat. Auf die Frage hin, wie sich für ihn anfühlt. Er spielt mit einer Big Band, ist neben fünf anderen Saxophonisten der gefeaturete Solist. Und er sagt im Prinzip sehr schön, dass es sich nicht anfühlt, als würde er alleine vor der Band stehen, sondern er dürfte mit der Band zusammen spielen. Er freut sich, dass mit einer so hochwertigen Band wie der HR Big Band zusammenspielen darf, die hart arbeitet und hart gearbeitet hat für das Ergebnis, das sie jetzt auch gleich noch weiter hören können. Und es fühlt sich gut an mit den Arrangements und Kompositionen von Guillermo Klein, weil sie sich lange kennen, weil es irgendwie durchaus anders ist als für andere Situationen. Er spielt auch sonst mit anderen Ensembles als Solist und ist sehr glücklich, dass es sich ein bisschen anfühlt wie in Kompositionen, die er teilweise schon kennt und andere, die neu dazukommen, aber in jedem Fall in einer Musik, die sich nach zu Hause anfühlt. Thank you.
Thank you.
For being with us in the break. I wish you a wonderful second half concert. Guillermo Klein, all the best. Miguel Zenon.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Ich wünsche Ihnen noch einen schönen Abend. Gregor Pramel sagt tschüss.
Musikredakteur Gregor Pramel hat sich in der Pause mit den beiden Gastsolisten des Konzerts unterhalten, dem puerto-ricanischen Saxophonisten Miguel Zenon und dem argentinischen Komponisten, Arrangeur und Dirigenten Guillermo Klein. Für den zweiten Teil des Konzertes Noticias de Zenon y Klein mit der HR Big Band ist die Bühne bereit. Wir sind wieder live im HR-Sendesaal.
Sharon, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That was Peter Reiter on the piano. Stefan Bieber on the tenor saxophone. So we started the second half with a couple of pieces. The first one you heard is a composition of Guillermo's called Venga. And the second piece, the one we just finished, is another piece from the out of the Puerto Rican songbook. This one was written by an amazing composer. Her name was Silvia Resach. And she's actually my mom's favorite composers of all time. I learned this song as a kid at home, listening to my mom sing it and listening to the records of Silvia Resach, and I sort of fell in love with the song. And every time I play it, I think of my mom and childhood. It brings back some really good memories. It's really, really a beautiful song, and it's a really, really good way for me to connect with home. And that one was called Alma Adentro. And we're going to continue now with another original by Guillermo, actually brand new. He wrote it for this concert. And this is another one that he wrote inspired by a poem, a beautiful poem from Argentina. And this one is called Canción Chile, right? That's what it is. Canción del Escalofrío. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
you. Bueno, this next piece we're gonna play is another very new tune that I finished this week. It's called A Uruguay. You know, Uruguay, they call themselves El Paisito, the little country, which is, Uruguay was part of Argentina until 1833, I think, and we are very alike with the Uruguayans. I was telling Miguel I was there in November, and I had a great time, and I hope we go to play there at some point, and I kept that in my mind. I was playing with the guys in Uruguay, and we were playing kind of something like this, so I tried to convey and share with the band and with Miguel the experience. So I hope you enjoy this too, Uruguay.
Thank you.
Danke schön. I want a very special applause for Jean-Paul Hochstetter on the drums. He makes something very complex sound easy. Thank you, man. The next piece is a tune that is called Quien te ve, that means, how would you translate? Quien te ve, who is seeing you, no? Who sees you? It's a very typical saying that says, Quien te ha visto y quien te ve, no? Who saw you and who sees you now? And it's a tune that I started in 94. I started it in 94 and I finished it like last year. Yeah. You know, started with lyrics and then the melody is very powerful and Miguel will make the best lyrics ever when he plays with the saxophone. So I hope you enjoy it. Quien te ve.
Thank you.
you very much. Miguel Zenón. Thank you once again for joining us and coming to listen our work, and it's been a great week, fun every day, every moment, and I would like to celebrate the band and introduce everyone to you before we play the last number. So, on the saxophones, Rainer Heute. Stefan Karl Schmidt. On the lead, Heinz-Dieter Sauerborn. On the alto, an amazing woodwind player, Oliver Leicht. Stefan Weber. On the trombones, we have the pleasure of having a bass trombone and a tuba, Robert Hedemann. From Norway, Christian Jaksjö. Amazing lead trombone, Gunther Bollmann. Another player that I met this week and I think is fantastic, Trevor Myers. On the trumpets, we start with Axel Schlosser. Martin Awa. On the lead trumpet, Frank Vellert. And Thomas Vogel. On the guitar, Martin Scales. Ayer estuvimos comiendo empanadas en la casa de Martín. ¿Hay algún argentino aquí? No. No puede ser. We were eating empanadas, you know, Argentine dish. His wife is from Argentina. It's great fun. Okay, let's move on. On the piano, Peter Reiter. And also, it's a big, big pleasure playing with him. I've been hearing him for decades, and I love the way he plays, and it's such fun to play with you, Hans. Hans Glavisnik on the bass. And on drums, Jean-Paul Hirschstetter. And I would like to, of course, as I said before, he's one of my favorite musicians in the world, and just, you can hear Miguel, sos un crack, man. Miguel Zenón. We're going to close with this piece called, thank you for staying, we're going to close this piece with this piece called Moreira. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you once again. This tune we're gonna play for you as an encore. It's a tune Miguel never heard, actually. You never heard this one, eh? It's called El Minotauro, and I wanna dedicate this tune from Miguel and me to a very good friend and brother, musical brother, is Juan Cruz de Urquiza, who I originally wrote this tune for. And I would love to hear Miguel. You know Juan Cruz, we know his son. So Minotauro, hope you enjoy. Thank you once again.
Thank you.